Hello everybody and welcome to EuroChannel. You all know from your own experience that the body is capable of powerful reflexes. One is sneezing, the other one is orgasm and, more specific for the purpose of this video, male ejaculation. In this video, I'm going to reveal mind-blowing facts of the body, including to what speed semen is accelerated, how far it travels, which muscles are responsible for distance, how they can be trained, and why hitting a wall actually can make you feel good. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a urologist with a specialization in sexual medicine and sports medicine. Sneezing and ejaculation are similar ways of the body to accumulate tension and release it with powerful contractions. There is a persistent myth on the internet that sneezing is related to orgasm because it yields the same feelings like an orgasm. But this is a myth, because it's simply not true. However, in sneezing, the airways clear at enormous speeds. Due to a forceful contraction of the respiratory muscles, air leaves the body at speeds up to 62 miles per hour. Depending on which study you're looking at, it can be less and also a bit more than that. Orgasm is quite similar because tension is accumulated until the point of no return and a powerful release happens. In contrast to sneezing, it is accompanied by feelings of happiness due to hormones that are simultaneously released in the brain. In men, ejaculation occurs at the same time and semen is expelled through the urethra. What many men don't know is that the source of the ejaculate is somewhere else than they would expect. The testicles are only responsible for about 5% of the fluid that's produced. 95% stems from the prostate and the seminal vesicles that are attached to the back of the prostate. In ejaculation, these three components are mixed together and placed in the back of the urethra. It is then expelled by the muscles of the pelvic floor that perform powerful contractions. In young men, 10 to 15 of those contractions happen on average. In the aging male, the number and force somewhat decline. It is the bulbocavernous muscle that is one of the main players here. It is positioned underneath the urethra and its rapid contractions shoot out the semen. When comparing this to sneezing, one has to keep in mind that semen is not air, so it is harder for the body to accelerate it to high speeds. But nevertheless, with the first contraction, it reaches speeds of up to 31 miles per hour. Now the laws of physics come into play. How far it then travels in the air depends on several variables: position of the body, height, length of the urethra, its caliber, the actual acceleration, volume, and gravity. I'm sorry, I'm unable to calculate that. I tried for almost 2 hours. But this is something for an engineer to do. So I have to rely on historical data from Kinsey and Masterson Johnson. They found distances between approximately 6.6 to 9.8 inches. This is very much dependent upon the individual circumstances. A strong pelvic floor is very important for the speed and distance that can be generated. Obviously, male porn stars train their pelvic floor regularly for this purpose. On the internet, I found a blog entry of someone who made use of the hours he had to spend at home during the pandemic to submit himself to a rigorous pelvic floor training program. The result was that he actually missed his girlfriend during sexual activity and hit the wall behind her. I will put a link in the description in case you want to read it yourself. Of course, this is the internet, and you never know whether this could be real. But I think it might be possible with training. Generally, strengthening exercises for the pelvic floor are beneficial. I have uploaded an exercise along video for the pelvic floor. From clinical experience, I know that some men have an overactive pelvic floor. If you want to know what this is all about, have a look at this video. Strength training with an overactive pelvic floor is not a good idea, as it will worsen the condition. So if you are in doubt, get a pelvic floor check first. If pelvic floor exercises get you near internet legend Horst Schultz, is doubtful. He is said to have reached the distance of 18 feet and 9 inches at a competition in Denmark, which translates into a seminal speed of 42.7 miles per hour. This is likely to be fake news, however, because there is no whatsoever additional information to be found, and it seems that everybody is copying from each other. Before you start your personal program, consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.